A wise man once said, Japan is a real mecca for gamers. Day one, went on a 13-hour flight, got there at 6 p.m., 5 a.m. for us, ate at TGI Fridays, went to sleep. Second day, we went to Kyoto, and Kyoto was about 2 hours away on a bullet train, so that was really cool. I got to see Mount Fuji, you know, pretty flippin' sweet, and a train got delayed because...
A person being struck by a train.
Yup. Kyoto was still cool though. We first went to this really cool looking imperial palace where I think the Japanese emperor stayed in like year 500, which was really cool. It's all made out of wood, so I don't know what they did in case of a fire. I guess they're just screwed, but it was really pretty. Speaking of pretty, Kyoto's pretty just beautiful in general. And you can see all the, you know, cherry blossoms, you can see those cool little anime things that they walk by in this video. And it's just, I don't know how to describe it. I really did not take enough videos of this place. Kyoto in general was just really pretty in a way that, you know, you couldn't see in other parts of Tokyo. We went to this temple with a name I cannot pronounce for the life of me. I'm not even gonna try. I might just put it up on the screen. And as you can see, there are a ton of people there. There was more people there than I saw in probably anywhere in Tokyo, in Japan in general. It was just like, wow. Of course, that was really pretty too. Look at this pagoda. I think it's a pagoda. Had a really nice view of Kyoto too. That's probably the cherry on top there. But overall, Kyoto was great. I really wish I, you know, spent more time there or even just took more video because there was not enough. I went to another temple. I can't remember the name of it for the life of me, but it was really good too. I just wish I, you know, had some video of it. I don't, and I really regret it. But that's okay because there is a lot of video where the next day is. I went to Akihabara. If you know what Akihabara is, you will know that I'm going to spend the next like 30 minutes talking about this and probably cut it down. Akihabara was something else. It's basically like Times Square for anime. That's the best way I can describe it. There's like anime everywhere. I mean, when I was in Japan, I really didn't see that much anime, like advertised and stuff. I really didn't see that much until I came to Akihabara and I was like, yeah, this is Japan. It was everywhere. I didn't know any of the anime that they were advertising, but it looks like they were advertising something. For those of you in the know, this is where the anime and visual novel Steins Gate takes place. And I played the visual novel, so it was really cool to, you know, see all these events in the game happen in real life. There's maid cafes, there's game stores, there's anime stores, and the main store I went to during my time at Akihabara was Radio Kaikan. Or Kaikan, I don't know. For fans of Steins Gate, it's the same building that the Time Machine drops on in the beginning of the series. They sold Steins Gate themed water bottles. I wasn't able to get a picture of that, but I didn't see any talks about time travel on the top floor either. It was really disappointing. But what wasn't disappointing was the building itself. It was 8 floors. There was figurines everywhere. A lot of Dragon Ball stuff, obviously, because it's, you know, one of the most popular franchises in Japan, period. But I saw a lot of Dragon Ball stuff, a lot of figurines in general, and I bought a lot of stuff, some of which we're going to get to later at the end of the video. Another amazing part of Akihabara was going to Super Potato, which is this old retro game shop, and it was 5 floors. A lot of stores in Japan just have a bunch of floors, I guess. And they had every video game you could imagine from up to like the PS2. So I bought Final Fantasy VI and Chrono Trigger for the Super Famicom. Can I play it? No. Can I look at it? Yes. Just a lot of merchandise, a lot of just things in general. They had a Virtual Boy there, a playable Virtual Boy. I played a Virtual Boy for 5 seconds. Wish it was more than that. I don't know what I was thinking, but I played it for 5. They even had a Wonder Swan. Whatever that is, it's a Japan exclusive console. It was there. If it's in Japan, it's in here. I also went to my first pachinko parlor. it's something else. I don't know why it's so popular, because every time I go in there, but I gotta say, Demotica Magica Pachinko, pretty sweet. The last stop I want to talk about is Softmap. It's just PC equipment, video games, that kind of stuff. And I went to get the Phoenix Wright collection for Switch, because that's physical and has an English release, so why not? And what really surprised me was the amount of PS Vita games available. I love the PS Vita, and I've not seen a single physical game for it in probably 2 years. And this had the most I've probably ever seen in my life. There was more Vita games than I could count. It was crazy. Now, I couldn't buy any because I had lost all of my money to figures and video games, so I could not take a single Vita game home with me, which was very disheartening. But I don't think I'd be able to understand it either, because it looks like they were all in Japanese. Oh, well, I forgot one last stop to talk about: the Sega Arcade. There is a lot of Sega arcades in Akihabara, and I went to one of them. There are these 7-floor arcades, each floor with a different theme, and I checked them out. I played House of the Dead, I played this one game called My My, which is the big circle, and it's a rhythm game, kind of like the Persona dancing games, and I played Taiko no Tatsujin, a drumming game that I got addicted to, and I played a lot of that. That's a lot of fun. I really like that game. I might even buy the Switch version, who knows.
If you know anything about the Japanese arcade scene, you know that there's a lot of people that get really into it, like this person here. This is just the kind of stuff you'd see all over the place in these Japanese arcades. I didn't try this one. It's like Dance Dance Revolution without the mat, but yeah, that's just too intimidating. I can't do that. So yeah, that was Akihabara. Definitely the highlight of my trip. There's a lot of things to talk about, some I didn't even mention. There's just a lot of things in general, a lot of video I took, pictures, that kind of things. Oh, I forgot, I got addicted to Gachapon, like really addicted. I went to the Square Enix store and they had an Octopath Traveler Gacha, and I was like, let me get some of that. So I went and I twisted the knob, and I was expecting to get a pin of one of the 8 main characters, and I got nothing. So I asked one of the people that worked at the store if they could help. So they rummaged around and got it to work again. They told me to turn it. I did, and I got 2. And I was thinking I was the luckiest man on earth, because I was gonna get 2 Octopath Traveler characters. And then the lady, she took them. She took my Octopath Traveler pins, and she said I had to choose one. So I actually got one. It was Tressa. That's pretty cool. She's one of my favorite characters, but still, like, I could have gotten 2. I'm just greedy. I'm just really greedy. So for the last day of Japan, I went to Ikebukuro, if I'm saying that right. I did not spend as much time there as I spent in Akihabara. I kind of wish I did. It was actually really cool too. There was, obviously the one place I wanted to go to in Ikebukuro above all was the Evangelion store. Yeah, if you don't know, there's an entire store dedicated to Neon Genesis Evangelion. So of course I had to go. It's actually pretty small, just a little room in a mall pretty much, department store pretty much. And they had all sorts of things. They had Misato's necklace, they had Eva shirts, Eva posters, Eva power tools, Eva, like, jewelry. I ended up getting a couple shirts, a poster, a keychain, some buttons, and these Evangelion finger puppets. So now even you can put your finger inside Shinji. Evangelion store was so cool. I wish they had more items. I looked online. They have so much more online than they do in the store. And there's some stuff online I would have loved to get in the store, but it's all so expensive. But I digress. I still spent a lot of money on there. And I also went to Don Quixote, which is pretty much, I don't have any pictures of this, but Don Quixote is pretty much just, at least the one in Ikebukuro, is a seizure in a store format. It is just so, like, much. Imagine a Target mashed into a singular room, and there's 8 floors. So you got like floors on floors on floors on top of floors, and there's no windows. There's like 5 songs playing at once. They're selling like toys, pool stuff, suitcases, anime figures, like anything you can imagine is sold there. And all of the
articles that you can buy are stacked from the ceiling to the floor, and everywhere you look, even my like borderline anorexic body could barely get through the shelves. It was just really bad. Also really fascinating just to see, I mean, look up the Wikipedia page. They have a separate little sub article just for their controversies. I mean, if you go to Japan, you should go here. It's just insane. For my last little stop, we went to the Parco department store, which is just a huge department store. A lot of huge stores in Japan. And on the top floor, they have this museum, and the exhibit was Yotsuba, just the drawings of the artist that drew Yotsuba, the manga. And I've heard of Yotsuba, I've never read it, but it was really cool seeing all of the little details. I mean, I never really noticed how much detail goes into manga pages until I saw that exhibit, and I saw like Yotsuba at the grocery store, and I noticed that every single like orange, like meat, fruit, vegetables, it's all drawn and it's all there, and I never noticed that. So, and I also started getting appreciation for Yotsuba, so maybe I'll pick up a volume one of these days. I ended up getting the Donbo little figure, the cardboard guy that you've probably seen everywhere. I ended up getting a little figure of that from Gacha, obviously. But that was really cool. I think that was the highlight of my Ikebukuro day. I had no idea it was going to be there when I got there, but I'm glad I went. This is actually part of a bigger Asia trip. I went to Seoul and Hong Kong. I wasn't at Seoul very long. I did have enough time to find an arcade that had Taiko, and I played Taiko a lot. Just played it for at least like 2 hours. I love that game so much. And that's pretty much it for Seoul. It looked really nice though, at least the little I saw of it. And Hong Kong was a stark contrast to Japan. It's like Times Square everywhere. There's like people walking all over the place. It's dirty. But I was able to purchase Super Robot Wars T. That was the only purchase I made in Hong Kong and Seoul, and it is amazing. I love this game. It is like Fire Emblem, a strategy RPG, except every time you attack someone, there's an awesome cutscene, and it's got Cowboy Bebop, my favorite anime ever. I've been working through the original Universal Century Gundam, so it's also pretty cool to see some familiar faces. Super Robot Wars T, I'm not going to talk about that much, because I might make a video on it someday. It's a really interesting topic, I think, that I could use for a video. So I went through all my stuff in this 30-minute long, extremely embarrassing video where I just sit there and stare blankly at every piece of merchandise while my mind grasps at something to just talk about as I'm standing there for 30 minutes saying, "Here is Asuka. She's cool." So I'm not going to do that. Instead, I'm going to cut down to the coolest parts of me just walking around my room after everything's set up. These are my Nendo droids. I got Kyoko from Monica Magica and Kamina from Gurren Lagann, my favorite anime character ever. He is so cool. And I love the Nendo droids. I've never had one before, but they are so much better than pop figures. I mean, like America, we have pop figures. Japan has Nendos, and they're just so much better. If you can't tell already, I got the card bow. I got the little cat thing for good luck. Got an Asuka figure. Couldn't leave without it. Best girl. I got a Goku figure. Future Gohan. I saw this and I was like, I have to get this. Gohan's my favorite Dragon Ball character, and this is the best version of Gohan. I had no idea this figure exists, but as soon as I saw it, I knew I needed to get it. There's also a Homura figure from, I thought it was from Monica Magica. It is, but for some reason the markings on the box was from some Magia Accord gacha mobile game. I don't know what that's about. I also got more of those finger puppets. I got this really cute Pikachu keychain. It was at the Haneda Tokyo Airport. This is an exclusive Tokyo Airport Pikachu. You cannot get this anywhere else except in the massively oversized Pokemon vending machine I saw at Japan at the airport. So I knew I had to get it. I'm not a big fan of Pokemon, but that was adorable, and also it's exclusive. Where else are you gonna get it? I also got a Moogle plush from the Square Enix Cafe. That was pretty sweet. They had these prints for the 30th anniversary of Dragon Ball's animation. So when the anime started, this was 30 years later. So I got one of, the only one I could find, of Beerus, Goku, and Champa. I thought it looked pretty cool. I picked it up, it was only $10. And then there was the poster for Evangelion, this awesome looking poster that was at the Evangelion store. I had to pick it up.
And that about does it for everything. So yeah, Japan was amazing, as you might assume. If you ever have a chance, definitely go. I'm sure most of you are probably really jealous. And I'm very lucky, and I really want to go again someday. Maybe next year, next century, decade, hopefully. But that's all I can say. Thank you for watching this extremely long, unscripted, kind of awkward to record video.